The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Sunday, March 20th, 2022, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, March 19th, 2022 was read and approved on motion and Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentations of petitions, messages from the Assembly. Reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Thank you, Madam President. I move that amendments are offered to the following third reading calendar bills by Senator Mannion, calendar 540, and by Senator Brisport, calendar 682.
The amendments are received. The bills will retain place on the third reading calendar. Senator Gennaris.
On behalf of Senator May, I wish to call up Senate Print 7861, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 430, Senate Print 7861 by Senator May, an act to direct the Department of Agriculture and Markets in cooperation with the New York State Energy Research and Development Authority to develop and produce guidance and educational materials on the use of agrobotanics in farming.
To reconsider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, aye 63.
The bill is restored to its place in the third reading calendar.
The following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place in the third reading calendar.
At this time, let's take up previously adopted resolution 2061 by Senator Kaplan. Read the resolution's title and recognize Senator Kaplan.
Secretary will read.
Senate resolution 2061 by Senator Kaplan, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul to proclaim March 21st, 2022, as Day of Nowruz in the state of New York.
Senator Kaplan on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. As the first Persian American elected to the New York State Legislature, it is my distinct honor and privilege to share the traditions of Persian culture with all of you. And today I rise to wish you all Eid Shoma Mubarak. As we pass this resolution officially proclaiming today as the Day of Nowruz in the state of New York. Nowruz, or New Day in Persian, is an ancient festival during back to the time of Zoroastrianism that marks the beginning of spring and celebrates the rebirth of nature. The secular holiday is celebrated by thousands of New Yorkers each year by gathering family around the ceremonial table known as the Hafsin, and counting down to the moment of the equinox when everyone cheers Eid Shoma Mubarak, or Happy New Year. Traditionally, the Hafsin table features at least seven items of good luck, each beginning with the Persian letter Sin, or S, and each representing a symbol of spring or renewal. You'll commonly see apples or seep representing beauty, garlic or seer representing good health, vinegar or serkeh representing patience, hyacinth or sunbul representing spring, a sweet pudding called samanu, which represents fertility, sprouts or sabzeh, representing rebirth, coins or sekeh, representing prosperity, a berry from the sea buckhorn plant known as sanjid, which represents wisdom, and the spice somak, which represents tolerance. Nowruz isn't just a time to exchange gifts and decorate a hafsin. However, it is the most important celebration of all Persian holidays, embodying a wealth of ancient rites and customs, and symbolizing the continuity of ancient Persian culture, which has survived many adversities over thousands of years. Today, I'm honored to share these traditions with all of you, as well as some of our guests who have joined us today to see this resolution passed. We have with us Betty Emamian, Persian Parade board member and planning committee member of New York chapter of Iranian American Woman Foundation. Rizwan Ali Mohammadi, representing the Ismaili Council, who have brought a group here today. And Wesma Wardak Hassan, founder, president, and CEO of Afghan Americans of New York. I believe she's also joined by members of organization. To our guests who have joined us today, thank you for being here. And to everyone here and across the state, Eid Shoma Mubarak. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. I don't know what else. Okay. The resolution was adopted on March 15th, and to our guests, happy Nowruz. Welcome to the Senate chamber. Thank you for being here today. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President, Senator Kaplan would like to open that resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Senator Gianaris.
Please recognize Senator Lanza.
Senator Lanza.
Madam President, by Senator Boyle, on page 13, I offer the following amendments to calendar 266, Senate print number 6142, and ask that said bill retain its place on third reading calendar.
The amendments received and the bill will retain its place on a third reading calendar. Senator Gianaris.
Take out the calendar.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 80, Senate print 4738 by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adavo Gianaris Cougar, Ort Sewer Cousins, White.
Senator Ramos, to explain her vote.
Madam President, thank you so much. I'm very proud to have introduced and passed this bill along with my colleagues. You know, the construction industry is changing. It's been very dangerous for a long time. And modular construction is increasingly a way to speed up the way we build things in New York City. And so I believe we shouldn't be doing that at the expense of worker safety. It's why we're establishing these standards, making sure that those pieces that we're bringing into the city are actually mindful of the licensing requirements in plumbing, in gas piping, in fire suppression, in electrical licensing. And these things are really important. Let me tell you, my district has actually succumbed to a few fires that we've had. And maintaining all of our electrical stuff up to code to the strictest standard is really important in saving lives and keeping people safe. So I want to thank all of my colleagues who are voting for this bill. And I vote aye, Madam President. Thank you.
Senator Matero to explain his vote.
Thank you, Madam President. And I'd like to commend Senator Ramos, for this legislation. Ramos, I said it right the first time. I don't know why I did that. This legislation protects the residents of New York City, and it protects all the local requirements that are being constructed properly. New York City building code standards. The modular units that are being constructed in other states, that's one thing that's an issue. Other states have different codes or they have no codes. So with something like this, it's so important that, in other words, the plumbing, electrical, the sprinkler, fire protection is being inspected before anything is being installed. Me, I always want to see these modules being built locally. But in the sense of with this bill, this is going to protect our residents before when they're installed and make sure that our New York City inspectors are looking at this and approving it for its being installed. So, Madam President, I am in favor of this, and I vote aye. Thank you.
Senator Matera to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 80, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Gallivan, Griffo, and Senator Kavanaugh. Ayes 60, nays 3.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 100, Senate Print 536A by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the real property law.
Read the last section.
Section 22, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 100, voted in a negative, Senator Lanza, ayes 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 105, Senate Print 4697 by Senator Breslin, an act to amend the general obligations law and the state technology law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 117, Senate Print 4965 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the public health law and the social services law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 180th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 117, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Jordan, Lanza, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 48, nays 15.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 126, Senate Print 6074A by Senator Salazar, an act to amend the Family Court Act.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 1st of April.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 479, Senate Print 7265 by Senator Kaplan, an act in relation to authorizing St. Francis Hospital, Roslyn, New York, to file an application for exemption from real property taxes.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 479, voted in the negative are Senators Akshar and O'Mara. Ayes 61, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 508, Senate Print 6289C by Senator Gorin, an act to amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect July 1st, 2023.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 522, Senate Print 6612 by Senator Parker, an act to amend the public authorities law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 30th day of the shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 672, Senate Print 6307 by Senator Harkham, an act to amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Harkham to explain his vote.
Thank you very much, Madam President. I rise actually not to explain my vote in the technical sense or to talk about what's in the bill because colleagues have been good enough to pass this 2 years in a row. The reason I rise is to talk about a group of extraordinary young people who are the folks who got this bill to us in the first place. There were a group of high school students in Long Island several years ago who wanted solar panels on their roof of their school, and turns out that the financing that was traditional through New York State did not work at 18 years, and they wanted to extend it to 25 years, which is a federal route. And they ended up forming a group called Students for Solar, and they have since expanded their advocacy. They're now a statewide group of high school students called Students for Climate Change. And so I just want to put it out there that regardless of age, you are never too young to have an impact on state policy, as we're witnessing here today, that this was a bill that was conceived by young people, advocated for by young people, and now this is the second year in a row that we pass this on the floor of the Senate. So I proudly vote aye and congratulate them for all their hard work and advocacy. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Harkham to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 674, Senate Print 715 by Senator Thomas, an act to amend the executive law. Pardon.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Thomas to explain his vote.
Thank you, Madam President. Fair housing is a right shared by all New Yorkers. In 2019, Newsday published Long Island Divided, one of the most concentrated investigations into housing discrimination since the enactment of the landmark Fair Housing Act. Long Island Divided uncovered tangible evidence of unequal treatment, steering, and bias directed at minority home buyers and minority communities on Long Island. In response, the New York State Senate launched an intensive investigation. Over the next 2 years, we held hearings, issued subpoenas, and compelled testimony to get to the bottom of these allegations. This legislation is a direct result of our efforts to ensure that every New Yorker is protected when they pursue the American dream of home ownership. This bill will ensure accountability for those who violate fair housing laws by compelling the Commissioner of the Division of Human Rights to award compensatory damages, punitive damages, or other relief to victims of housing discrimination. We are sending the message loud and clear: housing discrimination will not be tolerated in New York State. I want to thank Senate Majority Leader Andrew Stewart Cousins, Senator Kavanaugh, and Senator Skoufis for their leadership and continued commitment to addressing and ending housing discrimination in all forms. I am proud to sponsor this legislation. I will continue my efforts to ensure all Long Islanders and all New Yorkers have equal access to the American dream of home ownership. I vote in the affirmative. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Thomas to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 674, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Jordan, Lanza, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Steck, and Tedisco. Aye 51, nays 12.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk today?
There is no further business at the desk.
Move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, March 22nd at 3 p.m.
On motion, Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, March 22nd at 3 p.m.